Hello, I'm Bill Curtis, inviting you to watch the Philippe Matthews Show.
Welcome to the Philippe Matthews Show at thepmshow.tv. Named the Oprah of the Internet by Mark Victor Hansen, Philippe Matthews doesn't ask questions that are different. He simply asks questions that make a difference. The Philippe Matthews Show features entertainers, bestsellers, authors, thought leaders, change agents, and world-class experts in the field of personal, spiritual, and professional development. An internet marketing entrepreneur, Philippe is the creator of the How Movement, dedicated to teaching people how to move from the mindset of hope to the process of how. If you are ready to take your life to the next level, move from the mindset of why to the mindset of why not. Tune in right now to this latest edition of the Philippe Matthews Show and watch your life grow.
We're back, ladies and gentlemen, on the Philippe Matthews Show, and as you know, I am a cigar aficionado, or at least a cigar junkie, and as a result, I had a chance to have a tremendous smoked a couple of weeks ago by a company by the name of Arsen. And I love the cigar so much that I decided to talk to the owner. So I'm with him today, all the way from Miami, Florida. Arsen, how are you, my friend?
I'm very well, Philippe. Thank you. How are you doing today?
I am fantastic. Now, I love the name Arsen. How do you pronounce your last name?
Gasparian, Arsen.
Gasparian, okay. Now, you also named, you have two sons, and you named both of your sons Arsen. Is that so, just in case you forget one of them?
That's correct. So, their names are Arsen.
Hopefully, they will care, they will continue the family legacy and the family business, huh?
I hope so, Philippe. My grandfather's name was also Arsen. And, you know, it's a Latin word meaning strong, robust. And I think it's a good name for a cigar, too. I love and support my sons in whatever they choose to do in their lives. But cigars are something that you must feel passionate about, and you should love them.
Absolutely.
That's why it's absolutely up to them to get involved into this business that carries their name.
Absolutely. Now, speaking of your grandfather, that is, I believe, where you first began to develop your love for cigars. Take us back in time a little bit and tell us a little bit about your story with your grandfather and how he loved these great French cognacs and cigars.
Absolutely. Everything began with my grandfather's cigars, but surprisingly, he never smoked, Philippe. And he stored cigars and kept them on hand to offer to his friends and guests who wish to enjoy good cognac with cigars.
Is that right?
Yes, and he had an incredible collection of French cognacs, including Camus, Delamain, Martel, just to name a few. And, you know, all these cognacs were related to the name of Napoleon Bonaparte. And he collected all manner of cognac which somehow, you know, related to the name of the French emperor. And I remember those beautiful boxes of cigars which he kept in his humidor for his friends and guests. And sometimes, you know, I used to take these cigars to puff them with the friends at parties. And many years ago, my good friends Avo Uvesian, a founder of Avo Cigars, and Augusto Reyes, mm-hmm. who is one of the leading Dominican manufacturers of cigars, opened up the world of cigars for me from a different perspective. I have been many years in cigar business, almost 12, but 2 years ago I have decided to start my own brand and launched Arsen Cigars, the first line of Arsen Cigars.
Now, it was Avo that kind of inspired you to do so, is that right?
Yes, we met with Avo in '90s, and he told me that one day you should jump on it, you should do your own line of cigars. And then many years later, when I took my decision, I always remember his advice, and that was a great advice, I think.
Why, you say you've been in the business about 12 years. Why do you think it took you so long before you launched your own brand?
You know, before I was involved with wholesalers in overseas countries and here in the United States to launch different products of our factory, which is based in Santiago, Dominican Republic. That's the factory of Augusto Reyes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And, then, you know, it was a tough decision. It's something when you start, you have to be committed to this business and take proper care of the business and to make all your decisions regarding manufacturing, import, distribution. And it usually takes time because, for example, it takes 7-8 months to create the blend and before you launch the product, before you bring this cigar to consumers and to retail stores.
Walk me through that process, Arsen. You know, how did you approach your Arsen cigar? How did you approach your first cigar? Was the connoisseur selection? Is that correct?
Yeah, my first line of my cigars, Arsen Connoisseur Selection 2010. I launched in 2010 in November of 2010, and I worked around 6-7 months to create the blend together with Augusto Reyes and master blender of our factory. It's a long process to pick up all tobacco leaves for filler, binder, and wrapper, and then, you know, aging. Once the cigar is made, it's important to age cigars in the aging room so all these tobacco leaves can get married in a proper way before you bring them to the shelves of retailers.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Now, I remember reading somewhere that, you know, you kind of learned that there was a difference between Cuban cigars, you know, good quality cigars, in various parts of Europe, and you actually held a contest, a taste test contest. Talk to us about that, and because I don't think too many people have ever heard of this, that there's it tastes completely different in different cities and countries around the world.
Oh, sure. That was in Moscow a long time ago. I lived in Moscow and had a cigar magazine called Hecho a Mano, which means handmade in Spanish. It was the first Russian cigar and lifestyle magazine. And I did lots of tastings of different cigars under the auspices of the magazine. And we have decided to purchase the same Cuban cigars from different countries because we found out that legitimate Cuban cigars, they're different in certain ways. And there is a huge contrast between the same Havana purchased, for example, in London and in some Eastern European countries like Russia, Czech Republic. And to prove this point, we picked up four different cigars, different Cuban mm-hmm. cigars, Monte Cristo, Partagas, Hoyo de Monterrey, and Cohiba, if I remember correctly. That was in 2001. Monte Cristo number 2, Partagas, and Hoyo de Monterrey Double Corona and Cohiba Esplendidos. Mm-hmm. And we bought, like, all these cigars in four different cities, in London, in Madrid, in Moscow, and in Tallinn, the capital of Estonia. And I had a group of panelists, like 10 experienced cigar smokers who smoked all these cigars, and it was a blind tasting with this panelist and all experienced cigar smokers.
Okay.
They obviously knew what cigar they were smoking, but they didn't know in which city the cigar had been purchased.
Wow.
And this event took several days. It was fun. It was fun, Philippe, smoking all these cigars, discussing the difference between all of them. And the best cigars were the ones we bought in London and then Madrid, Spain. And the worst cigars were ones from Estonia and Russia. And then were even unsmokable. We couldn't smoke them. That's just the quality control problem they have in Cuba. Well, of course, Cuban tobacco and Cuban cigars are one of the best in the world. But sadly, Cuban cigars have declined during the last decade, and they have this inconsistency and quality control problems. This, for example, would never happen with Dominican cigars. I mean, you buy any Dominican cigar, the same brand, the same format in any European or American city or Asian city, they are the same.
Because is that why you decided to launch a Dominican cigar?
No, I mean, I have a special relationship with Dominican Republic. I used to travel a lot to Santiago, and Augusto Reyes, a very good friend of mine and manufacturer of many cigars, lives in Santiago, and his factory is based in Santiago. So I have been always in business with Augusto, and Dominican tobacco and Dominican cigars, they have very high quality.
Mm-hmm. Now, it was the kind of you who brought the art of fine cigars to Russia and the Ukraine and to that area of Europe, because before it wasn't really something that was a luxury. It was just, you know, something to do.
Sure. In those countries, in the beginning of the 90s, the cigar business developed pretty fast after the breakup of the Soviet Union.
Mm-hmm.
And in countries like Russia, Ukraine, cigar was a symbol of good life. And it still it is. Because cigars are very expensive there. I mean, you cannot purchase good quality cigar for $6-$7 in Russia or Ukraine or in other Eastern European countries because of the transport from major manufacturing countries like Dominican Republic, Nicaragua, Cuba, Honduras, and taxes and duties.
So,
but the cigar business is developing pretty fast in that part of the world. Also, you know, the United States is the number one market in the world. And
so when did you come to America? So when did you come to America with I know you just launched your brand in the last few years, but when did you come to America and why did you choose Miami?
It was 2004. I have chosen Miami, Philip, because our office was here in Miami, and Miami is very close to Dominican Republic. And, you know, when you travel pretty frequently to Dominican Republic, it's just 1 hour and 10 minutes flight.
Mm-hmm.
Very convenient. And my son was a professional tennis player, and he played in Spain, in Barcelona, and I also thought it's not a bad idea so he could practice here in South Florida. There are great tennis schools here. But then he quit tennis and continued his education. Then at the end of the day, I, you know, settled down here in Miami, and it's a great city. I love Miami.
Fantastic. So talk to me about your latest endeavor, which I think is complete genius, and I love the cigar called Pink for Men.
Thank you. I'm glad you love the cigar, Philip.
I do, I do, I do. It's a Dominican Puro, and so it's for men. It's for women too, but I mean, you know, you want to make sure you have something on your stomach before you smoke it, because it is a full body delicious cigar.
Thank you, Philip. I have lots of items of clothing pink color.
Mm-hmm.
Made by Pink. I'm sure you know this company, Pink.
Sure.
Thomas Pink. He was an 18th century London tailor who founded this brand, and then you know, we have Pink stores everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And also Turnbull and Usher. They're also London-based company, and they enjoy, I think, around 125-year heritage as a gentleman shirt maker and tailor. I think there are Turnbull and Usher stores in New York and in Beverly Hills in California. So I have lots of items of clothing of pink collar shirts, ties, bow ties, and other accessories. And it was actually my wife's idea. She told me, Arsen, if you have so many items of in color. Why don't you try to add this pink to a new cigar you are going to launch this year in August? Like, do a pink band and call it Pink for Men. And I love the idea so much, Philippe, that I jumped on it. I had the blend ready. We worked around 7 months to create this blend. All the cigars were in the aging room ready to bring into the United States. And we created this pink band. And Pink for Name for Men, I think it's a very great name. And I launched these cigars in August in Orlando at the International Premium Cigar and Pipe Retailers Association, Association Trade Show. It's called International Premium Cigar and Pipe Retailers Association Trade Show, shortly IPCPR. This is the oldest and largest and most active trade association representing cigar industry and assisting tobacconists. So we launched Arsen Pink for Men cigars at the IPCPR trade show in Orlando in August, and it was very successful launch. Number one, I think nobody has done it before, the pink band on a cigar. And I remember many, many cigar smokers, retailers, people of our industry were coming to my booth and asking to try a cigar with a pink ring. It was somehow a hit of the show, and we got lots of orders from retailers, many, many states, including California, Arizona, Texas, Maryland, Connecticut, Florida. And the number of these retailers who carry Arsen cigars, Arsen Pink for Men, is growing every month.
Well, absolutely. And you know, what I like about it is it's kind of like the world of bookselling. You got to stand out from the crowd. How are you going to leap off the shelf and look different? And, you know, it's one thing that, you know, you can't taste the cigar ahead of time, but if you have something that has a visual impact, it makes you ask the question, oh, what is this? Let me try this out. And then, of course, once you try it, you're hooked for life because it is an incredible cigar, an incredible smoke. Talk to us about the sizes and the shapes that you chose for the cigar and why.
Okay. Arsen Pink for Men line has four sizes. It's Toro, Robusto, Bellicoso, and Petit Corona. I have chosen these sizes because more or less they're best sellers, especially my Toro has 58 ring gauge, and the length is 6 inches. Robusto is always a bestseller. Arsen Pink for Men Robusto has 52 ring gauge, and the length is 5, which is traditional for Robusto. My Bellicoso is 54 by 6, and Petit Corona is a small cigar, it's a small cigar, 40 by 4, and I think it's a pretty good smoke after breakfast with a nice cup of espresso. You can really enjoy that cigar.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then, as you said, they are 100% Dominican cigars, Dominican Puros. All tobaccos we used to create this cigar are from Dominican Republic, and it's a medium to full-bodied cigar.
Incredible. Give me or give our listeners some of your recommendations on fine spirits and cognacs that would go great or pair great with Pink for Men and also with Connoisseur Selection 2010.
Okay, with Connoisseur Selection, Arsen Connoisseur Selection 2010, I think single malts are pretty good. We have tried different single malts, 10 years old, 12 years old, and more. They're absolutely very good with Arsen Connoisseur Selection 2010 with my first line. They complement each other very well. And with Arsen Pink for Men, I think some cognacs like Delamain, Hein, And some port wines would be incredible.
I can see that. A good port would be fantastic.
You know, and even with a good glass of red wine, both my cigars should be perfect because the taste and aroma, they can complement each other pretty well.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, where can people find a good cigar aficionado find Arsen Cigars worldwide?
Oh, they can find Arsen Cigars, both lines, in many tobacco stores nationwide. But Arsen Cigars are not available online. They're available only at fine tobacconists. And this is a concept of my company. And in the beginning, right after the launch, I made it very clear that Arsen Cigars should be available only in tobacco stores. And we do not work with wholesalers or internet companies. But the tobacco store, if the tobacco store has its own website, that's different.
Okay, okay. This is great.
The tobacconist can sell the cigars also on his own website. And he's not going to discount the cigar as wholesalers or internet companies do.
Sure, of course.
Try to keep the same price for the shelf and for his own website.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. I like that. I like that a lot.
Arsen Cigars are available in tobacco stores in many, many states.
Okay, fantastic.
And I also have the international distribution in some Eastern European countries. They are available in very good cigar stores in Ukraine, in Russia. But, of course, for me, priority is the domestic market, is the market of the United States.
Okay, very good. Now, you have a master blender that blended, I know he blended your first line of cigars. Who is your master blender? Did he help develop your Pink for Men?
No, the same people. I mean, that's a group of our factory, Augusto Reyes and Juan Rodriguez, who is the master blender of our factory, and myself.
Okay.
So three of us, we usually work to create a blend, and it's a fun business, Philippe. Really, creation of a blend. It's really fun, and you enjoy smoking all different cigars and trying to find exactly the, cigar which you think would be great for your target audience for cigar smokers.
Sure, sure, that'd be fantastic. So, what's next for Arsen? What are you working on now?
Now I'm just trying to build up the distribution of both lines, including Arsen Pink for Men. And I'll think about this after Christmas or New Year.
Sure.
But I'll definitely have a new line of cigars to be launched next year. But at the same time, I don't want to have too many lines. I prefer to have maybe 3-4 different lines for the next 4-5 years and to build up a proper distribution nationwide.
Fantastic. Very smart. Very smart. Arsen, thank you so much for being with me. I want to have you come back when you come out with that next line. You got me hooked. So the Philippe Matthews Show stands behind you. Arsen Cigars is a premium blend. Find out, go to your local tobacco store and ask for it or demand it if they don't have it. So thank you, my friend, for being with me today.
Thank you, Philippe. Thank you very much, and I'm very happy that Philippe Matthews Show is a cigar-friendly show. I appreciate it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We'll see you in the next issue.
Thank you, Philippe. Take care.
All right. Take care, Arsen.
You know, you're watching the Philippe Matthews Shows. Now, let me just give you my opinion. He is the Oprah of Internet. What that means is that he is getting together the biggest audience of people that want to make a difference in the world. And if that's you, you keep watching.